Finally, the countdown is just a couple more days until WWDC 18. Siri calls it that so I can call it that. It saves syllables, saves time, because we have a lot to talk about. All the potential of what iOS 12 could be. So I've been asking a lot of people what they want to see in iOS 12, and the most common theme I've noticed is almost all the ideas everyone can think of really just pertains to the iPhone X. I understand this a lot because it's a very unique Apple product. It's kind of the phone of the future in iOS 12. We'll be shipping with a lot of iPhones and iPads that are coming out in the future, but keep in mind, guys, that iOS 12 is going to be running on the iPhone 8. It's going to be running on the 7, the 6S, the 6, potentially even the 5S, as well as all of the iPad Pros, the iPads, a bunch of devices that do not have OLED displays. So when we're always talking about what we want to see on the iPhone X iOS 12, let's try to keep in mind that there's some other devices that will be running this as well. And I don't think we should exclusively leave all of our ideas for just the iPhone X. But since so many of you have had requests, since so many people have requested so many different things, I want to highlight what I think most people are wanting out of iOS 12 first, and then make our way down. By far the biggest requested one has to be a certified dark mode. Just a UI that means pixels are flat out off, to which I have to repeat, guys, Smart Invert is getting better and better and better. It works on Twitter now, it works in messages, it even works on YouTube, and it will activate the dark mode of YouTube when you activate Smart Invert. It even works in Instagram, in Mail. It's just, they're getting really, really good at knowing what images not to invert colors on while inverting all the rest. In order to have an official dark mode, there's only a couple things they would actually have to change. Smart Invert works in Apple Music now as well. It's just been through so many updates, and I think that it's not very hard to turn on. If you go into settings and activate Smart Invert, you just have to click your home button 3 times, or if you're on an iPhone 10, click the side button 3 times. And I think you guys should try that, because surprisingly, a lot of apps now support it, even third-party ones. But I understand you guys want it to be more official, you want it to be in Control Center, and you want it to work universally no matter what app you're using. All I'm saying is the difference between an official dark mode and the current state of Smart Invert wouldn't be that big. And what I found funny is just dark mode is by far the most heavily requested thing people are looking for in iOS 12. And iOS 11, and iOS 10. This has been a long time coming, and I kind of hope Apple just does it to silence these requests. The second most common request I think I've ever seen for iOS 12 is stability. This one is hard to kind of specifically point out, because you only notice stability when it's not a problem. iOS 11 was a bumpy release for a lot of people, depending on who you ask. If you ask someone like me or iUpdateOS, iOS 11 has been pretty much fine for us, and we loved all the new changes, and we haven't had a lot of glitches. But if you watch other YouTubers, some people can say that it like destroyed their whole phone, made the whole thing slow, and made it crash 5 times a day. That was something that was regular for a lot of people. So most with iOS 12 are just hoping that there will be less bugs, which I think is very hard to guarantee. Mostly because glitches and software bugs are never intentional. So going into an iOS update trying to promise that won't happen is kind of an impossible promise, because Apple, as they're making iOS stretch across a 12.9-inch iPad Pro and work all the way down to a 4-inch iPhone, and there's a lot of differences between those devices, I think there's just less people working on each device, which means that there's a lot of bugs, there's a lot of software that can't universally be supported and be verified that it won't have problems. I'm sure they're gonna do their best to make this a stable release. There's even some reports saying that Apple is delaying some user interface changes just so they can make iOS 12 a more stable update and make iOS 13 next year a more graphical redesign. Which brings us into our next idea. A heavily requested feature is people want a user interface change. People loved updates like iOS 7. Even though it could be a lot slower for your device, the change in UI was a very welcome one and a very fresh one. And given a lot of the marketing we're seeing for WWDC, a lot of people are thinking there's going to be more 3D animation in the redesign of iOS, and it's going to be a graphical improvement. I'd be very curious to see that, if they add a bit more shading, if you just look at things like apps that embrace the new WWDC graphical look. If that's coming to the entire interface, I'll be very curious, but given we're also getting a lot of reports that iOS 12 is more about stability than graphical changes, I'm not really sure which one we're gonna see, but let's hope for both. Next is a bunch of ideas people have for the iPhone X. A definite, very highly requested one is being able to remove the notch in the interface. This is something I thought we were gonna see before the iPhone X came out, but Apple just went full on notch and said, nope, we're supporting it, we're embracing it. But many other Android phones out there are providing the option to cover up the notch if you so desire, and I think it would be smart in order to compete compete with all of these Android phones and compete with all the people who have issues with the notch or who make fun of the notch, and just go ahead and iOS 12 add an option to black out those bars. Even though I don't think I would do it personally, I've seen iPhone 10s that cover up the notch by graying out those pixels, and I don't think it makes the phone look better. I think it makes the bezels look kind of lopsided, and I'm not a fan of it, but adding that option in the settings, I think a lot of people would be happy with Apple. So if you decide to do that, you're gonna get a lot of praise from your audience. Next, people want changes to the lock screen. The fact that an iPhone 10 basically has two buttons at the bottom that allow for 3D touch for flashlight and 3D touch for camera, even though you can swipe it to the camera anyway. Why does that button need to be there? People want to be able to customize those to different buttons, whether it's the phone or the calculator or just something else. Maybe turn them off in general. People want more customization over those little 3D touch icons at the bottom. People also would like to see Face ID work in horizontal or portrait mode, because currently unlocking your iPhone 10 with Face ID only works if you're looking at it straight ahead, and if you're using your phone in landscape or upside down, Face ID just will not work. I think iOS 12 would be a perfect time to enable Face ID to work in different orientations, because there's still a chance that iPad Pros might be refreshed at this keynote. Yes, I see the reports. Some people are saying there won't be any new hardware at WWDC. Some people are just saying no new iPads or MacBooks. I understand that's possible, but in the near future, Face ID will be adopted on iPads, and iPads are made to be devices that work in any orientation. So it would make sense if Face ID in iOS 12 can work in different orientations. It sends a dot projector of IR sensors in a circle. It does not have to work in portrait mode. The hardware doesn't say it has to work in portrait mode. It could easily work in a horizontal interface, and Touch ID works in any orientation as well. So why not Face ID? Some people, again, as we're talking about the iPhone 10, would also like to see an always-on display, just using those pixels at a very low power mode. And I'm not into that, but a lot of people think it would be good to have that as an option, given it wouldn't use much power. It could compete a bit with the always-on display on Galaxy S9 and other Android phones. You could see what notifications you have without necessarily turning the phone on. But personally, I don't think Apple's interested in that, because they like the look of a clean, blank sheet of glass when the phone is off. And I don't think Apple wants us to mess with that. But who knows? Maybe we're getting through to them and they're getting these ideas, like maybe having a red dot at the top of the screen when you have notifications, just like an Apple Watch does when you look at your watch face. Which also brings us to another very popular request, the option to make animations a lot faster so that the speed test can go a lot more in the iPhone X's favor. People have discovered that in speed tests, compared to a OnePlus 6 and an iPhone 10, the OnePlus 6 is a lot faster, but it's not necessarily because of the CPU. It's only because the animations in iOS are a lot more dragged out. And if those animations were minimized to where anytime you open an app, it just instantly opens, it doesn't have to give in that blow up animation where it takes up the whole screen, or when you go home, you need to see the app close down into the home screen. Instead, if you swipe up, you just instantly go home. If you tap on an app, it just instantly opens. Perhaps providing an option for people who don't need those smooth UI changes and just want their phone to work as fast as possible, iOS 12 could result in iPhones being a lot faster, as long as it's not turned on by default, because I think Apple very much appreciates those graphics and those animations, and it can help people who aren't as good with smartphones understand what's going on with the screen if it's not jumping around all the time. The OnePlus 6 also has done something very smart, which is that if you don't have notifications on your lock screen and you try to unlock your face, it will immediately just jump to the home screen. But if you do have notifications, then it won't jump to the lock screen, and instead it will just unlock but show you those notifications on your lock screen. Personally, I think that Apple should have an option for that if people who want a faster UI and don't want animations to be bugged by anything. Perhaps Apple could make it an option so that when you look at your iPhone 10 and Face ID unlocks, it'll just instantly jump to the home screen. I think that Face ID is a very secure and fast unlocking mechanism, but the reason it's so much slower than the OnePlus 6 face unlock or iris scanning or Touch ID is really just because of that drawn out animation and the fact that it requires you to swipe up to get to your home screen. Maybe make it an option to just jump to the home screen if there's no notifications. Obviously, if there are notifications, just leave it on the lock screen. While we're talking about the lock screen, still a lot of people are complaining about notifications on iOS 11 and how there's too many of them. They want it to be more like Android. They want it to group together so that if you have 20 notifications from a specific app, it will just bundle them all together and you can expand it if you like. Personally, I think if you're getting 20 notifications from an app, you just shouldn't have that app set to push notifications. I think the fact that people run into this problem is because they're so used to Android, where there's so many pop-ups that you're constantly hitting allow, where on iOS, I don't think you're supposed to be constantly hitting allow. If it asks you for notifications, but you get 20 notifications an hour, maybe just don't hit allow. And if you want to check those notifications, just go ahead, open the app and look at those notifications. But Apple, I don't think, should be relying on the customer to figure these things out. Obviously, obviously a lot of people are not understanding that for certain apps, you're not supposed to hit allow push notifications if they send you too many. So I think it would make more sense for Apple to take it upon themselves to make the UI easier and to make the lock screen a bit more concise, even if someone is used to hitting allow, allow, allow. Instead, group all these notifications together. You can 3D touch on them if you want to expand and look through all of them. But yeah, if you're still having that problem, I'd recommend just not having push notifications for apps that send you tons of notifications. I'll admit though, Apple should take that upon themselves. It shouldn't be on the consumer to figure that out. Now there's plenty of other iOS 12 concepts out there that I've seen that I kind of try not to look at because they have really, really good ideas. And usually when I see them, I get my hopes too high and then I just know it's not gonna happen. So I try to not think about it, but I'll give you one for example. The idea of combining the contacts app, your phone app, and messages into a single app, just calling it messages, because if you get voicemail, it's a message. If you get a text, it's a message. And all it basically is the iMessage app, except at the bottom, there's different tabs. You have messages, contacts, and keypad. This makes so much sense to me because most people are texting, not calling anymore. So have messages be the default, but if you need to call someone, obviously you move to the middle and there's the contacts app. Then you can tap on them and FaceTime audio them or just voice call them. And then if they're not in your contacts, just go to keypad and dial the number directly. Combining those three apps into one app, I think makes a lot more sense and would make the home screen and all the apps that are included with iOS 12 a lot more minimal. Combining FaceTime, phone, contacts, and messages, that saves up some storage, that saves up some home screen space, but that's a really good idea and they're probably not gonna do it, so sorry to get your hopes up, but hats off to that concept artist, that made a lot of sense, as well as their design for a redesigned cover flow, so that if you're in Apple Music and you switch to landscape, you get this beautiful look of all your albums. That's a good idea, but they're not gonna do it, so I hate getting my hopes up like that. Now on top of that, I wanna quickly address a giant one that a lot of people are still requesting. Yes, we all want a better Siri. We want Siri to be smarter. We want her to be contextually aware. We want her to be able to hear two commands and put them together. We want Siri to be able to search the web and find the best answer. So essentially, we want the Siri to just be more like the Google Assistant. If you want to hear more about our thoughts on Siri on Talos of Tech, we did basically an entire tech podcast recently on iTunes and on SoundCloud, if you don't have an Apple device, where we basically just talk about all the potential Siri has and the fact that she's getting further and further behind a Google Assistant, but it's probably not a priority for Apple to fix her because they know that having a good digital assistant does not result in good sales. Apple's had Siri for a very long time and they've still remained one of the best-selling smartphones. So it's safe to say people do not buy phones based upon how smart the voice assistant is. However, the Google Assistant is very smart, very capable, and when we use certain Apple products, when we use certain Apple services, we expect them to just work. And the fact that Siri is a service that you can say anything you want to and just talk, the potential of what Siri could do and the capabilities of what Siri should be able to do is basically infinite. So when we're used to Apple services that just work and we find one that doesn't just work at all times, it's very easy to critique. So yes, let's very much hope that in iOS 12, we get a massive Siri overhaul. I'm not gonna guarantee it. I think it's probably not gonna happen, but I would like to see Siri get some massive changes and make her a bit more comparable to the Google Assistant without tricking people on the phone that they are a person, because that's a little weird and probably not what Apple would do. There's also some talk saying that Apple is going to be unlocking the NFC chip in all our iPhones with iOS 12 to make them a bit more capable. I happen to agree with everything Apple Pro on this one by saying that I don't think they're gonna open it up so that any developer can access it because it's another way to hack into an iPhone. But what they're probably going to do is verify certain developers who let NFC work with door locks and stuff like that so that if you get approved by Apple's App Store support, then NFC will be unlocked for your specific app and NFC can be used for things more than just Apple Pay. I don't think it'll be open wide just like Android is. However, I think the door will be opened wider than it currently is. And there's already some reports that people at Apple are already using these NFC unlocked chips to open up doors for security purposes and stuff like that. And it'll be cool that they'll be allowing that for all users once iOS 12 is available. If you want some personal suggestions for me, I still would like to be able to change my recording resolution and frame rate from the camera app just by allowing 3D touch. I don't think this is much to ask, but I'm gonna keep asking for it every year. Please, Apple, we'd like to change our record resolution. Please don't make us go to the settings app every time we wanna make that happen. Of course, there's more customization options I'm seeing a lot of people want. Like, one I thought was a cool idea was, what if, just like the photo album watch face, where every time you look at your watch face, it changes a picture? What if your iPhone lock screen could do that as well? I think a lot of people would appreciate every time they look at their lock screen, it's a different picture from a selected number. Perhaps some more default wallpapers as well, because there's not too many in the iPhone right now. And definitely should we see a change change in the volume indicator. It's ridiculous that our volume still appears right in the center of the screen and covers up a lot of what we're watching. So let's hope that, like several concept creators, they put the volume indicator in one of the ears next to the notch for the iPhone X. And personally, I would be fine if the volume indicator just wasn't there at all, because if you're listening to something, you can hear the difference with the volume. You don't need a visual. And if you're not listening to something, why do you need a volume indicator? You're not changing the volume for anything. You're not listening to anything. That was a bug in iOS 11 for a while where there just was no indicator, and I actually really liked it until I fixed it. Some people still want the Taptic Engine to go off when they're typing on the keyboard, which I don't know if Apple is into. Maybe it hurts the battery life too much, but you know, Apple sometimes has to give in to what people are asking, as they did quite often with iOS 11. That would be kind of interesting if they added it. I think it would change the way we type every time now, because we'd be getting so much Taptic feedback. And as we're getting to the bottom of the list now, some people still want group FaceTime calls, which I've actually done on Skype. So if you can't do it in FaceTime, just keep in mind you can do it on Skype anyway. But it is kind of nice to be able to video call two people at once. Even though I've said in the past, I don't think it's very intuitive. I think internet for a lot of people has gotten good enough that that can be a natural, normal thing. So being able to call several people while FaceTiming at the same time, I think a bit more users would appreciate. And I think the list continues to grow and grow, and there's no really conceivable way I can put every single iOS 12 suggestion into one video. But listening to your guys' suggestions and watching a lot of videos about iOS 12, I think this is as far as I can get. There's all the ideas we have. It's a very packed potential OS, but I don't want people to get their excitement too high, because I don't think iOS 12 is going to be a big update. I think it's going to be fairly minimal, fairly basic, and focused more on stability. And I'm really hoping that it will work on every device that runs iOS 11. So that includes the iPhone 5S, even the iPod Touch. And I think they need to focus on just nailing down what features they already currently have, and probably not too crazy on adding a bunch of others. Most of the iOS 12 changes, I'm guessing, are coming to the iPhone 10. So thank you guys for your suggestions. If there's some big suggestions that you think I missed out on in this video, please let me know in the comments below. This is your Apple Sheep here, and I will see you in the next one.